So, we need Max back. Our hacking is way too low for that. The restroom? No one in the restroom. What is this? Wait, oh. One way to go. Is the other one sealed?
Joy and happiness. It's really more like a dull complacency. Things are fucked. But you have enough spectrum and stop caring for a little bit.
Alright, sure. Ludovico's under attack, but we'll look at this stuff. Harvesting. It all starts here at the orchards. Our purple berries are harvested at peak edibility. Is that a word? Edibility? Making them a perfect base for our brewing process. Brewing and bottling. Our refined distilling process has been honed by years of experience, not only efficient but highly effective at bringing out the most powerful flavors from our ingredients. After the beverages are ready, we bottle them up and ship them out straight to the thirstiest mouths in the colony. Brewing and bottling, so I didn't really look. Yeah, there's the parasite thingy. It's still alive in there. Oh. We can't actually view a thing on that. Well, this is the finished product. What about... Oh, that's it? What about this? Atmospheric collection. Did you know that? This facility doesn't just distill alcohol. We distill fuel right out of the atmosphere. That special flavor present in every bottle of Rizzo Spectrum Vodka also gives our fuel its unique kick. That we use the same containers to brew our beverages and store our raw fuel. I got another door here. And then we got retro rockets. Which is what exactly? What are retro rockets? Junk? Is it junk? Been a while since we sold our junk. I guess it's a consumable thing. I'm not sure. I mean, in any case, we have four of them. It's a dark matter bar. Is that it? No, here it is. We have eight of them. Old-fashioned gummy rockets in a variety of flavors. Ooh. That sounds good. Old-fashioned, that's why they're retro. Huh. Rizzo's Beverages. Spectrum Brown, a bold and full-bodied spirit with earthy notes and an indescribable savory flavor, dissolving into a hint brine, culminating in a bitter yet satisfying cocoa-adjacent aftertaste. It'll leave you smiling for days. If you're interested in trying this unique flavor sensation, proceed to the door to your right and follow the path to the tasting room. The door to the right, tasting room. Or they mean this right. This comes back out here. I didn't even see that door, actually. Oops. So where's the door to the left go?
Nice done.
Thank you. Oh, a storeroom? With a secret way through. That's why I saw a red thing pop up on my meter there, my little bar. Alright, let's go through and see what there is. Still got all those other doors. Oh, we're back behind it. Oh. Recharge? What's that? What's a recharge? Try not to think too hard about how this one works. Hmm. Okay. Oops. Was it setting up to make a video or something? I can't fit back here. I can't fit back there. Yeah, they were filming here. Weird. Halcyon Helen's monogram cigarette lighter. This lighter, inscribed with the initials HH, have featured prominently in each of Halcyon Helen's starring roles. Oh, this? It was a gift from an old flame. Ha! Never leave home without it. Never know when it could save your life. Hmm. So they're filming her serials here, then. And here's an empty bottle of Spectrum Ground. Needler prop. This looks like a prop used during the filming that took place on this set. Not much of a weapon. It's too fragile to even pistol whip someone. Hmm. Disappointing. Well, very interesting, I must say. I wonder why it was sealed off like this. Oh, and that's not a real door, okay. And then back here. We can't actually walk through because the tripod or whatever's there. Wait a second. Oh, okay, this way. Very interesting, indeed. Warning, no trespassing. Distillery. Behind this, or beyond this door, we hope to make some of your wildest dreams a reality as we give you a peek into the heart of our distillery. You can see it all for yourself, clear as crystal. Please refrain from sharing our secrets with unauthorized solicitors. Let's just keep this special experience between us. Oh yeah, boy. So he's what? He's down in any case, whatever that is. Here's those this way.
Mm-hmm. These tanks are hard at work brewing the wonderful rhythm beverages you I think they meant horrible new crimes against humanity, like Rizzo's Spectrum Brown.
That's exactly what they meant.
Now that you've seen behind the scenes, I bet you're pretty thirsty. Well, not to worry. We have every flavor of Spectrum available to delight your palate. Please note that tour guests are limited to a maximum of 3 different Rizzo's flavor samples.
Too bad.
All beverages must be consumed on the premises.
I'm taking them off.
Is not responsible for gastronomic distress.
How about being
job? We are on the job.
How about being
take mine to go?
Overweighed. Yeah, you'll take yours to go. Well, employer rights under the Biased Labor Standards Act. Wage determined by merit of your work. Overtime may result in higher pay if the quality of said work is considered exemplary. Your employer has the right to dock your pay should you damage any facilities or equipment. It is your responsibility, not your employer's, to avoid workplace hazards. Halcyon Colony Department of Labor stinks. So, we just picked up all this stuff. If I just add it to junk, does that take the weight away? Makes a weird sound. I don't think it is taking the weight away. I know I picked all this stuff up, now I'm dropping it. Alright. I'm gonna drop all my junk. That should have us go down. Tainted meat. I think it's good enough for now. I'm littering! Yay! Oh, back out here, okay. The only place left to go. Can't pick those up and then drop them. Is this way? Oh, sealed. How do I get in there? The other way. I'm back outside, I think. Hold on. There's an elevator over here somewhere. What lurks in these waters?
Staying out of sight.
Sealed. Alright, stand by, guys. One moment. Okay. Whoa. Oh, a reenactment of the serial? No? Is it real? Is it
It's you.
You're alive?
I had a feeling you'd catch up to me sooner or later, Inspector. I was just hoping you'd find me standing over the Administrator's corpse.
Ha!
What in law's name? Halcyon Helen. How are you still alive?
Yeah, I figured.
Oh, is that Ludovico I hear? Perfect. I'm so glad he's still in the building. Would you mind letting him know I'm about to blow his whole operation to flinders?
That's a fair question. You want to explain how you're still alive?
Brace yourself, Inspector. You're about to learn the biggest secret in the Aetherwave industry.
That you're alive?
Halcyon Helen was never one person. I shared this role with my twin sister.
Huh?
Belinda.
Oh my god.
Are you serious?
So her corpse...
Halcyon Helen's got a twin sister?
Had.
I mean... Yeah. It's obvious. You know, if you... Think about it.
She doesn't even know.
Linda and I were the best kept secret in the business. Nobody could tell us apart. And certainly not a peevish, petty, miserable little worm like Quentin Ludovico. Huh? When I discovered the truth, when I realized what Ludovico was about to unleash on this colony, Belinda paid the price.
Right, she found out about the Spectrum Brown parasite things. So, you know... I figured she might be alive. I'm trying to move her face from side to side. But, that was just a guess. And as far as Ludovico, no one else fit. And I'm not sure he fits either, but... I don't think it was any of the other four. You used me to pin this murder on someone else. Lou? So this is... I'm saying this to Ludovico, then. Use me to pin this murder on someone else. I don't like being used. Lou. Yeah, I just want her to say it. What plan are you talking about?
My plan to save Halcyon. I'm not a murderer, Inspector. I acted in defense. I had to defend Halcyon's future.
Not talking to you.
Tell the truth, Ludovico. There's nothing safe about Spectrum Brown. You want to infest this entire colony with those disgusting parasites.
They're not parasites. These creatures are symbiotic life forms. They belong to the highest order of life form, capable of living in perfect harmony with humanity. The symbiotes evoke a feeling of joy in their host. A bliss so pure, so profound, as to render the most exquisite recreational substance obsolete. Oh, don't you see, Inspector? I want to bring joy back to Halcyon. I want this colony to smile again.
Yeah, this guy's, a little nut job. They're not symbiotes. I've seen the way the infected behave.
A host only turns violent if they're carrying too many symbiotes, or if they see you as a threat. In its natural state, the relationship between symbiote and host is perfectly harmless. Listen to me. I never wanted to take a life, but I had no choice. I couldn't let anyone destroy this colony's only chance at real happiness.
But
what about
happiness.
Helen? What about all the innocent people she's killed?
No one I crossed off was innocent.
Hmm. That was you in the labs. You killed Dr. Blossom?
Have you met Dr. Blossom? She was practically a reptile. A cold-blooded psychopath who toyed with human lives in the name of scientific advancement.
Pretty much.
Your Blossom wasn't a person. She was a weapon in Ludovico's arsenal. You call it murder? I call it disarming my enemy.
And I know you killed the Ranger's mascot.
The mascot was a spy working for Ludovico. He was ordered to keep an eye on Belinda and I, and report back to his master.
You're being paranoid. I barely knew the fellow.
Don't try to deny it. Anywhere Belinda and I went, that mascot was there, just watching us with those cold, dead eyes.
They didn't see you together, though, right? I'm not gonna say this because I don't know if he was or wasn't working for the administrator. I found him rummaging through your things.
That doesn't surprise me at all. He was on Ludovico's side, just like the others. Dr. Leora Blossom, Maria Keene, that
Constable Keene?
Black wit of a mascot. They were standing between me and Ludovico, so I did what I had to do. I went through them.
You killed Constable Keene? She was on your side.
She was on Ludovico's side. When she realized I was alive, she refused to stay silent. I gave Maria a chance. I told her about Belinda. I asked for her help, but she turned me down. She was honor-bound to report me to Ludovico. Maria had a duty to her company, and I had a duty to Belinda. We both did what we had to. But in the end, I was the faster shot.
Alright, I've heard enough.
You know what you need to do. Help me avenge Belinda. Help me put a stop to this.
Don't listen to her. Listen to me. Throw in with Helen and you destroy Halcyon's only chance at real happiness. Think of the future, Inspector. A lifetime of bliss and joy for every colonist in Halcyon. We can make that happen.
I'm helping you, Helen, but once we get out of here, I expect some answers.
It's a deal.
The lesser of two evils, I suppose. Let's get...
We don't have a lot of time. We need to get out of here.
Not so fast. I've sealed the bulkhead doors. You're staying right where you are. I'm sorry to do this to you, Inspector. Truly I am. If it's any consolation, Helen has brought some remarkably powerful explosives. Your death should be instantaneous. Goodbye, Inspector. Helen, we won't meet again.
Damn it. He sealed us in, but I think I know another way out. Follow me and stay close.
How do I follow you? You're behind the thing. What? How do I follow you? Oh. Doesn't look very safe. It's sealed. Oh, you opened it. Wait, which one? Oh, this? Switch down. What switch? Down. Switch? How do I do it? Oh, this. Whoa!
We made it. Nice work, Inspector. We may have put a stop to Ludovico's operations, but he's still at large. He's probably gone into hiding, so we're going to root him out.
What's the plan?
This entire complex has been exposed to those parasites. Law only knows how many they've infected. Most of them won't even know they're carrying a parasite inside of them. If they're showing symptoms, it's probably already too late. Boundless energy, insufferable joy, an almost saccharine attitude of optimism.
And violence.
And just like that, parasites bursting out of their bodies. Fat and wriggling with vital energy.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't eat anything at the hotel. There must be some kind of pesticide. Benign to humans, but lethal to parasites.
You're a step ahead of me, Inspector. Clearly a woman of many talents. An airborne pesticide of some kind. I think you may be onto something. Let's meet back at your penthouse. We'll ready our next move.
Wow. Halcyon Helen in the penthouse with us? Well, I have some questions.
Not here. In private, back at the penthouse. Also, I rather like the ambiance there.
Oh.
See you soon, Inspector.
Okay. I don't think there's anything back there to loot. Oh. Oh, wow. Comes out of there. Alright, back to the penthouse then.
You think they'll let us expense the booze?
There is such a thing as too clean. We ought to break open a few bottles and have some fun. Make a what? You think they'd object to me setting up a tanning station here?
A tanning station? This centrifuge was stolen from the Rizzo's R&D labs. You see a small label stuck against the side of the device. The label reads, Rizzo's Laboratory Centrifuge. No training required. All Rizzo's laboratory equipment has been designed for use by the unschooled worker. Insert ingredients, push buttons, and watch it spin. Rizzo's proprietary technology, so easy a spacer's choice worker could use it. Peel back the label. You see another smaller label under that one. It reads, discontinued model, spacer's choice proprietary technology. So they... Yeah. They took a Rizzo's... Discontinued Rizzo's... I mean, discontinued spacer's choice thing and made it Rizzo's. Terrible. Truly terrible. Right, Sam?
Sam's special inspector add-on includes a magnifying glass to sleuth out the germs and parasites that other cleaning products leave behind.
Okay. The number of cigarettes here indicate that the smoker's lifespan has been shortened by approximately 11.2 years. We can tell that?
The opulence of this place is stifling.
So where's Helen? I guess she's... Oh yeah, there. So I think some things have been added. But I don't think anything's been added in here. Ludovico? There's no response.
This room ain't so bad. I could get used to this.
No, she wasn't.
It's strange. When you walk through that door, I half expected to see Belinda.
No.
Belinda and I practically shared a life. Losing her feels like losing a limb. She's conspicuous by her absence.
I'm sorry. This must be difficult for you.
I appreciate the sympathy, Inspector. Thank you. I'll appreciate your help even more. We shut down Ludovico's distillation plant, but he's not going to sit idly by. If he can't use Spectrum Brown to infect the colony, he'll resort to some kind of backup plan.
Hmm.
I stole this formula from Dr. Blossom, a failed prototype of Spectrum Brown. Look at this. The prototype had the opposite effect, and actually made you immune to the parasites.
Oh. Well, I mean, this is obvious, but I can't say it. Your immune system could destroy the parasites before the larval stage. Um, reading the formula and also slightly depressed instead of incredibly happy.
This is Halcyon. Everyone's already miserable. A little more despair isn't going to make a difference. We're going to need two ingredients. A sample of essence of Sprat and one intact pod of parasite eggs. Cedric's warehouse in the Piraeus spaceport almost certainly carries a batch of Sprat essence. As for the pod, I'd check the wilderness reserve if I were you.
I should be able to synthesize an effective anti-parasitic.
You're a scientist and an inspector? You really are full of surprises. I borrowed a centrifuge from the research lab. Use the ingredients to synthesize an anti-parasitic.
Yeah, I'm a Redditor and a Discord admin. Okay, easy enough. Centrifuge from the research lab. Easy enough.
I'm glad I could count on your expertise. Once you're finished, head to the pilot house. We'll hijack the control system and disperse the cure into the atmosphere. That should kill off most of the parasites.
I don't think I need her needler. Most?
The more severe cases are beyond saving. I'm afraid there's not much we can do for Groundskeeper Yarbo. There is one other thing. While you're at Piraeus Spaceport, have a word with Cedric Kincannon. I know Cedric. There's nothing he wants more than a chance to eliminate Ludovico. We could use him on our side. Best of luck, Inspector. I'm counting on you.